Hello and welcome to a new video about control engineering. Last time we talked about how we can get the frequency response out of the transfer function. Today we want to do an example. Last time we had a transfer function looking like this, g from s. Equals 3 divided by 1 plus s 0.1 multiplied. And we said we can easily replace s with j omega and then formally calculate the frequency response. So we had this g from j omega equals 3 divided by 1 plus j omega 0.1. Okay? This was the example of last time. And we said, okay, if this is the case, then our total value of this is the total value from here. So it's 3 divided by the total value of this, 1 squared plus omega multiplied by 0.1 squared and the square root of this. I explained it last time. This was the absolute value. And then we had the argument. This turned out to be minus arcos tangens from 0.1 multiplied by omega. And I said, we can calculate for different omegas those values. So here I've prepared a Bode plot. And you see there are 0.001, 0.001. So we'll use those values. So we make it a table, right in omega. And then we have the absolute value and the argument. Here we will produce a table with values. And we will start at omega 0.0001. Okay? Here. 0.0001. Here's my calculator. I will switch to complex numbers, and I want to have it with absolute value and argument. So this is rather easy, and I will also switch to complex values. Then I have seen here, I can see here, okay, that's it. So the only thing you need to enter is actually this formula, this one. So it's 3 divided by 1 plus, and now of course the imaginary part is here I. So I multiplied by 0.1 and multiplied, and now I take this omega 0.0001. That's it. And I should get the result. Here we have it. 3 total value. And the argument is minus 5.73. 10 raised by the power of minus 4. Not that big. So let's look at 0.001. Here we have 2.999. So 3 again. And there something has happened. It actually looks like the same, but it's raised by the power of minus 3. Okay, looking good. Yeah, let's see 0.01. Yeah. 2.99, again 3. Yeah, but however, the 9 is getting less. Yeah, so the 9s are getting less, so we're reducing. Yeah, here is 3, here is 2.99999, here is 2.9999. Ah, here we have already something, minus 0.0573. Yeah, so again, 10 raised by the power of minus 2 this time. Yeah. So let's see 0.1. What has happened here? What will happen here? 0.1. Uh-huh. 2. Nah, still 3. Still 3. And we have minus 0.573. Okay. And 1. Okay. At 1. We have 2.99 and minus 5.71. Okay, now something moves. Let's see, 10. So 10. One, minus 45 degree, I should write also, minus 45, then we have 100. I really changed something. 0.299 actually, yeah, so 0.3 minus 84.29 degree, yeah, and 1000, zero dot 0.299 0.03 actually, minus 89.43 degree, yeah, and now 10,000. To be complete, this now is really small. 3 raised by the power of minus 3. Yeah? And minus 89.94 degree. Yeah? Let's see where a lot of things change. Maybe we should calculate 5 here. There's quite a lot of change, so maybe we calculate 5 as well. Let's see, 5, so that's 2.68, yeah, and minus 26.57, yeah, and there is also a lot of happening here. Let's calculate 50 as well, yeah, 50 means 0.588 and minus 78.69. Okay, so this is the table now. Okay, with this table, I can draw the border plot. So if I'm using now these numbers here, are they in the picture? Well, should be. If I'm using now these numbers here, yeah, so at 0.01, I am at 3. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, I'm here. At 0.001, I'm here at 3. At 0.01, I'm here at 3. At 0.1, I'm here at 3. At 1, I'm 2.99, so I'm a little bit below. Yeah. At 5, I'm 2.68. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2.6. So here, yeah. At 10, I'm at 2.1. Yeah, so a little bit here. Yeah. At 50, I'm at 0.6 around, 50, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 0.6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 here. Okay. At 100, I have 0.3. 1, 2, 3, I'm here. At 1000, I'm at 0.03. 1, 2, 3, here. Yeah. At 10,000, I'm at 0.003. 1, 2, 3, I'm here. So this actually is what I've calculated. Look at that. Here we're dropping. Passing, and here we're also dropping. Remember this one? Looks like a PT1 element. Okay. And if I'm extending this here, and extending this here, I will meet at exactly 10 seconds, and this is 10 seconds raised by the power of minus 1. This was the PT1 element. Let's also draw the argument. Okay, let's draw the argument. So at 0.01, I'm at 0. Minus 0, also minus 0, 0.0, maybe a little bit, note disable, 0.1, a half degree, also a little bit, at 1, minus 5, here we have already something, minus 5, we're here, yeah, at 5, we're at minus 26, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 26, so we are somewhere here. Okay, at 10, I'm at minus 45, we are here, at 50, we are at 78, 10, 20, 30, 40, 40, 50, 78, 75, 80, 78, here, around, at 100, we are at 84, so we are pretty much here, At 1000, we are at 89. And at 10,000, we had almost 90. So this actually is the phase. Okay, and here, like we've learned in measurement, we have exactly this minus 45 degree. Okay? This is coming out of the math here. Yeah, beautiful. So, you see, we can produce the Bode plot simply by changing this S to J omega. I show you something else. I also show you the Nyquist plot. What the Nyquist plot is? The Nyquist plot is actually holding the same information as the Bode plot, but in only one diagram. Sometimes it's easier to look at the frequency response in the Nyquist plot. How the Nyquist plot looks like, I'm going to show you. So actually, it is just a drawing of the imaginary and real axis. So if this is the real axis, real, then let's say here 0, here's 1, here's 2, here's 3, yeah, here's minus 1. Yeah? And then we make the real axis as well. At imaginary axis, of course, real axis we've just shown. So here is j, yeah, here is minus j, here is minus 2j, and so on. Okay, and now I'm doing pretty much, I'm drawing the same values like I used for the border plot. I'm drawing now simply in this as imaginary numbers in this. So I will try this now. First point at omega 0.001, we are at 3 and minus very slow. So here we're at omega equals 0.0001. Okay, the second one is almost there as well. The third one also half a degree and 3. Let's see if I can, if I could manage this. Probably not. I will not even try. Yeah, it's because also this is here. 1, 2.9, minus 5. This is getting a little bit more interesting. Let's see if I can manage to draw this minus 5. Where I'm ending up here. Here this line, so it's minus 5, it's here, here, and like this, and 2.9, so here. I've used 2 centimeters by one number, so it looks like this. Yeah? Next one, minus 45, oh, make this, minus 26, minus 26, 2.7, minus 26, see, 26, 2.7, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, here. Yeah. So this here is omega equals, what was this, minus 5 degree, 1. This here, omega equals 5. And now omega equals 10, minus 45 degree and 2.1. Minus 45 degree. Two dot one, a little bit more here. Yeah. Here we have omega equals 10. It's actually this. Omega equals 10. Then we have 50 minus 78 and 0.6 minus 78. Like this, minus 78, and we said 0.6, 0.5, 0.6. Here, yeah, here, this would be omega equals 50, yeah, and then at 100, 0.3 and 84. Let's see if I can still draw this. 80. 84, 84, 0.6, 1, here, yeah, this is omega equals 100, yeah. This one, make it a little bit bigger, those points, yeah. Then at 1000, we are also here and here. So we are ending up at a graph looking like this, like a half circle. That's the typical graph of Nyquist plot of a delay system first order, and these are the growing omegas. Okay, these are the growing omegas, and this is the Nyquist plot. So for every omega, we have a point at a curve at the Nyquist plot, and this will then show the frequency response. Yeah? So this here was called Bode plot. And this here is called Nyquist plot. Okay. Also somebody from the past. Two different variants on how to show the same thing. Sometimes it's easier for us to look in the Bode plot, and sometimes it's easier for us to look in the Nyquist plot. This is why I told you how both of them were working. Add one example. You should now be able to draw a Nyquist plot or a Bode plot of almost all or every transfer function you like. So you now can draw Bode and Nyquist plots out of any transfer function you look into. So that's for our example, for our frequency response. Next time we're talking about standard elements. What are standard elements? This was already one standard element. This was a PT1 element or a system first order. There are several standard elements. What we do with such standard elements and why we can use standard elements to describe our reality will be covered then in the next video. So next video then, introduction to standard transfer elements. For this time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.